There is something common between you and me. Like you, when I was a beginner, the thing that bothered me the most about playing the guitar was actually getting it in tune and keeping it in tune. I was so scared of tuning that every time I picked up the guitar, I used to wish and pray that it stays in tune, because I never wanted to go through the activity of tuning the guitar again. I've also seen many of the beginner students struggle with this thing when they first attempt at tuning the guitar. So if this is something that you are also having a hard time with, then stick around. Today you are going to learn how to approach tuning the guitar properly, and we'll take this opportunity to build your musical knowledge and at the same time ensure that you never break another string while trying to tune the guitar. Welcome back, this is Dhanesh, learnguitaronline.in, and in this short lesson you are going to learn a lot of new things that is going to make you a better guitar player right in this very moment. You will learn what is tuning, then we'll talk about standard tuning, which is what you're going to be dealing with most as a beginner player. You will also learn how musical pitches move so that you can tune the guitar without breaking your strings. You will learn an easy method to remember the notes on all your open strings while you're in standard tuning. Then I'll take you through the process of tuning the guitar so that you can follow along and get your guitar in tune right now. And as a bonus, you will get 5 best practice strategies for beginner guitar players that will guarantee faster progress for you. I remember when I tried to tune the guitar for the first time, I ended up breaking the first string. And it was a horrible experience, so bad that I used to feel overwhelmed with the thought of tuning the guitar. And that one thing kept me away from playing guitar for months. Now, most of this comes down to one common mistake that all beginners make, which is not understanding how musical pitches move. And that is why you end up breaking strings and not being able to tune them quickly enough, and eventually end up feeling overwhelmed and frustrated. Because getting one string in tune itself is a task, and let alone doing all the other 5 strings. Now let's look at how you can easily tune the guitar without going through any of these struggles. Tuning is the activity of getting the strings adjusted in such a way that it produces a certain musical pitch. If you look at your guitar strings carefully, they are hooked up over here, and they can be controlled with these knobs over here, which is also known as the tuning pegs. And depending upon in what direction you're going to rotate these tuning pegs, the length of your string is going to increase or decrease, and that will make a change to the musical note that it's going to produce. So if you have got your guitar set up properly from a proper technician, then the tuning will always work clockwise, it will increase the pitch, and counterclockwise, it will decrease the pitch. Most guitars will have this kind of a headstock where you'll have 3 tuning pegs on the top and 3 at the bottom. So these 3 are for your bass strings, which is 6th string, 5th string, and 4th string. And starting from here, this one is for your 3rd string, 2nd string, and 1st string. Now, if you happen to own a Strat or any of those models, you might find all 6 tuning pegs in line. But remember that it always goes from the 6th to the 1st string. So there are various kinds of tuning, and they are used for different purposes. Now, as a beginner, you don't need to be worried about all different types of tuning out there, because what you will be focusing on right now is something that is more commonly known as standard tuning. Now, before we dive into tuning the guitar and end up making the same mistakes that other people make, let's first take this opportunity to build up our musical knowledge and lay down the foundation of musical information that is going to be the basis for you to get better at creating music, learning music, and getting ahead of the pack. Now, what you see in front of you is how the musical pitches move. And it's not very complicated to understand. I'll break this down into simpler terms so that it becomes very easy for you to not just understand this, but also remember this. Like you have alphabets in any language, like you have alphabets in English, there are 26 alphabets, whereas music has only 7 individual notes, or they are also commonly referred to as pitches. So imagine that if we start our pitches on the letter A, then we can max go up to G. And what happens after G? A shows up again. So all these pitches keep repeating, and we term them as individual octaves. If you have ever had the opportunity of looking at a piano, you will find that there is a set of 12 keys which look identical, and the same set of 12 keys keep repeating throughout the piano depending on the range of the instrument. So what's happening is those 12 keys are your musical pitches, and the same pitches get repeated as you travel along the octaves, and same thing happens on the guitar as well. You have all these different frets, around 120 frets that you have on your guitar, but in music there are only 12 unique notes. Now out of the 12 notes, we are here only talking about 7 pitches, because this is what I want you to focus on right now. There are some other pitches also which we'll discuss probably in a later lesson, but at this moment try and memorize this information. So 7 musical alphabets. If you start on A, you can max go up to G, and then you have to repeat from A again. Now these pitches, what you have to focus on understanding is that these pitches move in both directions. Pitches can start lower and they can go higher, whereas they can start higher and climb down as well. So once you understand this information, you will know where your string is at when you're tuning the guitar, and that will ensure that you don't end up breaking a string in the process of tuning, because you'll know exactly how much you have to move in order for the string to get to the right note that you're looking for. Most of the guitars out there will always be in standard tuning, and many of the songs that you hear are also in standard tuning. Now, next step is for us to memorize what are the pitches that we want on each of these individual strings. And for that, you can make use of simple acronyms that will help you to remember. So on the 6th string, which is the thickest string, and this is how I recommend all students to tune the guitar. Start from the 6th string and go up to the 1st, rather than doing it this way. You can do it that way, many people do it that way, but I recommend you start from the 6th one and then travel up to the 1st. So on the 6th string, you have the pitch E, and on the 5th string, you have the pitch A, on 4th string, you have D, on 3rd string, you have G, 2nd string, you have B, and on the 1st string, the E repeats again. So remember that 6th string and 1st string have the same pitch, same exact pitch, but having different frequencies because of the type of the sound that the string produces. Now, how do you remember this stuff? Memorize an acronym, something like elephants and donkeys grow big ears. So E, A, D, G, B, E. You can use other acronyms like Eddie, A, Dynamite, Goodbye, Eddie, or there are many others out there. Stick to one, pick any one that works for you, and memorize the names of these strings that way. Now let's talk about what are your options to tune the guitar with. So as a beginner, you are definitely going to need help tuning the guitar, because your ears are not yet accustomed to hearing the sound of the notes and identifying whether they are producing the correct pitches. So you have to depend upon a simple tool called as a tuner. And there are two kinds. You can either have physical tuners that can be clipped onto your headstock, or you can have virtual tuners which are in the form of applications on your phone. I highly recommend you invest in a physical tuner, because there are many advantages to this. Because you clip this onto the headstock, it picks up the vibrations of the string. So it is not bothered by all the other sounds that are happening around it and will produce accurate tuning for you. But if you don't have one right now, do not worry about it. Pick up your smartphone, download any app, any good tuning app. I've been using an app called Smart Chord on my Android phone for a long time, and I like it because it has many other tools also apart from tuner, so you can check that out. If you're using the physical tuner, then it might have multiple options, so you can tune many other instruments with the same tuner. So ensure that you have selected the proper configuration for the guitar. On the physical tuner, even if there is no sound coming out, you can still see that it's showing me the right pitch. So that's my 6th string. Now, as we discussed earlier, on the 6th string, the note that we are supposed to have is E. So we can see an E, but this accelerator kind of thing is right now on the towards the left hand side, which means the pitch needs to be increased, which means the string length needs to be shortened so that the pitch can move up and come to the middle where it will mostly show a green light in on any tuner. So let's do that. So now in order to increase the pitch, I'm going to tune it up. So like we discussed, I'm going to rotate it clockwise, whereas you can feel this, okay? If you have restringed the guitar on your own and if you missed some step and you did it incorrectly, do not worry about it. While rotating, you will feel it. When it is tightening, you will feel that the string is tightening. When you're loosening it, you will feel like the string is going loose. You can check it, double check it from here. So let's see how we can get from this E, which is not there yet, to the right note. So you saw that it became green when it hit the center, so that's what we want. Now next we move on to our fifth string, which is supposed to produce the pitch A. That is also tuned down a bit. So now it's up to the pitch. Let's go to our fourth string. Now it's up to the pitch D. Now what I wanted to discuss is about overshooting. Let's say sometimes the pitch goes higher than what is required. Then in those cases, all you have to do is just drop it down. But I would recommend that you drop it down slightly below the center point where it's supposed to be and then tune it up again. That will ensure that your string does not have any slack. Alright, let's do our third string. Now when you get to third string, second string, first string, this is where you have to be careful because these strings are slightly thinner in nature. And the second and the first string are the most vulnerable to breakage while tuning. So let's do our third string. So third string, now this is how I'll rotate clockwise to get it up. Second string, we need B over here. And first string, we need E again. So right now it is showing E, but it's towards the left a little bit. Now, one most important tip is once you're done with the activity of tuning, always recheck starting from the sixth string again, because the activity of tuning itself might throw some of the strings out of tune. So just recheck and fine tune if you feel like it's still not there. Alright, so that was the process of tuning. I hope you were able to follow along with me and tune your guitar also. If not, ensure that you watch the video again, watch the tuning part again, and how I was getting it up to the pitch and getting it in tune. Now let's talk about some important things while tuning the guitar. So you have to keep the string in action. You have to keep articulating it at regular intervals, because if it loses the articulation, then it's not going to move the things on the tuner. Do not get frustrated if the tuner is taking a while to get warmed up to the right notes. You may not be articulating the strings harder enough for the tuner to hear, especially when you're doing it on an app. If you're tuning using an application or a physical tuner, which is generally using its mic to hear the pitches and then help you tune, then in that case, ensure that you're sitting in a quiet place where nobody else is there, no noise around you. Keep the tuner right in front of the guitar and articulate the strings harder enough for the tuner to hear. Now, when you're tuning with an app, something like E flat, A flat, G sharp, F sharp, these notes might come up on your tuner. Do not worry if it shows the right note that you want. For example, if you're tuning up to a G and the tuner is right now showing a G flat, that means it is not there up to the G. It's almost there, but not there yet. So you have to tune it up to pitch. If it shows G sharp, that means you have gone sharper than the pitch. You have gone ahead of the pitch, so you have to bring it down. Now, some important things about tuning the guitar that I wanted to share with you. And this is the critical point. Even if you didn't pay attention to anything else there, over there, make sure that you listen to this very carefully. Go back and listen to it again, because this is what's going to lead you to musical and guitar playing success. I understand that the activity of tuning in the beginning can feel extremely overwhelming. One of the main reasons is that this is a new thing to you, and you have to take this into consideration. Everything new that you do in life has provided some kind of challenges to you. But trust me on this, these challenges are temporary, they are going to fade away, and this will become like an elementary, most basic thing that you will do as a guitar player. The beauty about this is, once you go through this grind a few times, once you pick up your guitar and you tune it a few times, you will realize that it's not much of an activity. You will feel like I was getting scared for no reason at all. So my recommendation to you is, every time you pick up the guitar, check whether it is in tune. This activity of playing the strings and checking whether it's in tune is going to lead you into passive ear training, developing your oral skills in recognizing the pitches. At least you will get to recognize whether your pitches on your open strings are sounding exactly as they are supposed to be, and if not, then what kind of adjustment you have to make. When you make the adjustments, take into consideration how musical pitches move, like how we discussed, seven pitches, and they move in either directions. So for example, if you are on a D and the note that you want on that string is an E, then you know that D and E are very close by to each other. E comes just after D, so you have to ensure that you don't overshoot and do a lot of rotation on the tuning pegs to get to that note. So rotate it at a slower speed, not extremely slow, but at a slower speed, depending on wherever you are in terms of the musical pitch. And above all, if the strings break, do not worry at all. Strings are not promises. They are meant to be broken. They are meant to wear out. Strings are like fuel in your car. You know that if you have a car, you have to refuel it. Just like that, when you're a guitar player, you have to restring the instrument. Strings are going to wear out, they are going to rust, and you don't want to be playing with older strings. So if they break because of playing, then congratulations, you should be proud of yourself. You've been playing well and you've been doing a lot of work on your guitar playing. But your goal from this lesson is to understand the process of tuning and never break another string in the process of tuning. Like I said in the beginning, as a bonus, you are going to get 5 best practice strategies for beginners that will guarantee faster progress for you. And all you need to do for that is go to the link in the description below. If you love what you're learning here, then smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and turn on your notifications so that you can know whenever I upload the next lesson. Send me your queries through the comment section, or let me know any other topic that you would like me to cover through these lessons. Share this video with all your friends who want to learn, so that you can also help others. For more such bonus guitar learning resources, head over to learnguitaronline.in. This is Dhanesh again, and I'll see you at your next lesson.